Good morning, Cornerstone.
Good morning.
How are you?
Great.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Well, you need to say it with a little more energy. How are you, Cornerstone?
Yeah.
Ah, that's so much better. I want to welcome you to our 10 o'clock service. It's good to see your smiling faces. And I also want to refer you to our bulletin of all of the different things that we have going on this morning or throughout the week. So there's too many things to say up here this morning. So you have your bulletin. There's a lot of great things coming up in the next week. Please refer to that. I just have a couple of things to explain this morning. So we have one registration in the great room for Vacation Bible School. And it's a great experience for the kids. I will say it is my kids who brought me to Cornerstone. They came to the Vacation Bible School, had such a great time, understood the love of the people and the love of God, and that drew Janice and I to this church. So get your kids in it. They'll have a great time. Also, I just want to welcome our visitors. If you've gotten a visitor card from the welcome desk out front, please fill it out. And if you haven't already given it back to the person at the desk, please feel free to put it in the box at the back. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. So at this point in time, I'm going to turn this mic over to a fantastic person. Yes, you should anticipate. A person filled with the Spirit of God. A person that just loves God and loves other people. I want you to give your biggest white teeth smile,
oh my Lord,
to the Reverend Dr. Pastor Tracy Sillette.
I take them all out to lunch every week, make sure that that's what they say beforehand. So good morning, everybody. Welcome to summer. Welcome to summer. Let's all stand. You know, I was thinking this morning, you know, when we come together in this space, we're not coming and entering worship to conjure God up. Or, you know, if we sing really hard and in a frenzied way, that the Spirit will suddenly fall. God's presence and His Spirit is here now. We enter worship and we recognize our eyes are opened to see that He's here even now. And this morning, I mean, Joni a while ago said this. She said, you know, when I enter worship, she goes, I recognize that we are entering with that great cloud of witnesses. And that it's our eyes that are opened to that great cloud of witnesses. And this morning I was thinking about Psalm 139. And David writes this, Lord, you know everything there is to know about me. You perceive every moment and movement of my heart and soul. And you understand my every thought before it even enters my mind. You are so intimately aware of me. You read my heart like an open book, and you know all the words that I'm about to speak, even before I start a sentence. You know every step I'm going to take before my journey even begins. And you've gone into my future to prepare the way. And in kindness, you follow behind. With your hand of love upon my life, you impart a blessing to me. See, when we enter into worship, we're just breathing that Spirit in. We're saying, Lord, you know us. You know who we are. And we want to see you. Open our eyes to see you. Open our eyes to see that your presence is here already. There's a song that we're going to go into, and it's going to be the second song, and it's called Lay It Down. And this is what I want to do, because I don't want to interrupt the song. I'm going to say this. If there is something that you've brought in here this morning, or there's some burden that you're carrying, or maybe you're carrying fears, or maybe you're carrying pain, or maybe you're carrying concerns about a job, or maybe you're carrying financial, whatever it is that you have come in here, I believe that God is calling us to lay that down this morning. So the altar will be open during that song. I want to specifically, because the Lord gave me things specifically about laying them down. I was in here the night they were practicing. And this is what he said. Lay it all down. Paradigms and lies, arrogance and pride, thinking we know it all, being right, manipulation, lying, hopelessness, unforgiveness, depression, pain, hurt, fear, even privilege and victimization, bitterness, even not listening. Listening to lies or gossip, unbelief, not trusting, lay it all down. Even those things that you beat yourself up about, lay it down. So this morning, let's open our hearts to see him. Lord, open our hearts, open our mind, open our ears to see that you are here right now in this moment. And Lord, you are calling us this morning to lay everything we got down in your presence, in this moment, and not take it back up again. So, Lord, we say yes to you. We say yes that you are here in this moment. We say yes to entering that great cloud of witnesses even now. We say yes that your presence and your spirit is here, and we recognize you. Lord, as always, we give you permission. Have your way. Not our will, Lord, yours. In Jesus' name, let's worship, church.
that second verse. You didn't want heaven. Here we go. You didn't want heaven without us. Jesus, you brought heaven down. Your love is great. What could separate us? Beautiful, wonderful. Put under the name of Jesus today? How do you need his name to be above something in your life right now? Just think on your in yourself. Just think of how you want Jesus' name to be above something right now in your life. We place all things under your name today, Jesus. Put you above everything, Jesus. The name of Jesus above all things in our lives. Death could not hold you, the veil torn before you. You silenced the boast of sin and sing it out. What a beautiful name. The name. Truth today, Jesus. We sing your beauty. We sing your glory. We sing that you are worthy of our lives. We sing about who you are and the truth of who you are and compare that to our circumstances or the lies we believe or the things we need to lay down, God. And we put you above everything. Jesus, the name above all names. We sing your truth today of who you are in our lives today, Jesus. Bring your word, we grieve in pain. Every cause you have for shame, lay it all down. Lay it all down. When your cares have buried you, and there's nothing left to do, lay it all. Lay it all down at the feet of Jesus. At the feet of Jesus. Lay verse again. Verse one. Bring your worry, grief, and pain. Every cause you have for shame. Lay it all down. Lay it all down. When your cares have buried you, and there's nothing left to do. Lay it all. Once again, we're praying the truth over the lies. Because sometimes, and I've seen it and I've heard it just recently, the lie can be so real that you actually act it out and you react to it. So that your whole life and the path that you're on becomes a reaction to a lie instead of what the truth is over your life. So if you look at your life and you say, what am I believing? That is not true. What am I carrying that is I shouldn't be carrying? That I'm holding on to as though it's the truth, as though it's something I need to do. And it's become so much a part of me that I don't even recognize it anymore. Because I believe it as truth, but it's a lie. And it's taking those things in our lives and laying them in Jesus' presence, laying them at his feet. So that you can hear his truth about your life and you can hear his word over you and you can say, he says, I want to carry that for you. You don't need to carry that. I want to be your truth. I don't want it to be the thing that you have made up in your mind, that lie, that thing in your life that has taken over so much space that you can't even hear or see what he's saying to you anymore. Believe his truth today. Believe his truth over anything that has come into your life that is representing itself as true but is a lie. Get rid of it. I don't care what words you use. If you don't use lay it down, just get rid of it in Jesus' name and walk in what he has for you today. Let's do that. If we all do that together, imagine it, the freedom. We all do that together. Literally, the lies that people believe, it can transform your whole life because you act out what you think is true, but it's a lie. It can be in your family, it can be at work, it can be at church. Oh, that person hates me. So you act it out. You walk in that as though it's truth. The enemy has us in circles sometimes. Let's just break it in the name of Jesus. We just sang about how Jesus is above everything. Let's just break it open. Lay it all down, lay it all down, lay it all down, lay it all down. Lay it all down, lay it all down, lay it all down, lay it all down. Lay it all down, lay it all down, lay it all down, lay it all down. At the feet of
how you know that you haven't laid it down. Here's how you know that you're believing a lie. that you may not even know that you're believing a lie because you don't have peace. If I am not walking in a place of peace, that means I'm believing something that is not true. Doesn't that sound profound? If I'm anxious, if I'm fearful, if I'm angry, if I'm bitter, you look at the fruit that's going on in your life. And if the fruit that is in your life is something other than a place of peace, then you got to go over here and go, I got to lay something down here, Lord. Something's not lining up. It's not that we go into condemnation or feel bad. It's just a diagnostic. It's just, you just look and you go, look at my fruit. Where's my fruit? Okay, this situation, I got a lot of fear about. This person's really making me angry. This one, I want to lash out here. Whatever it is, you just go, that's a diagnosis that I have something that I'm not trusting God in. And God calls us to lay it down, not for condemnation, but to go, I want you to be free. I want you to walk in a place of freedom. So diagnose yourself. Take a look. Be honest. The only way that we're going to ever change is if we're honest before God and go, okay, show me my own heart. Every day, I'm laying something down. Because every day, I have a place of growth. The altar continues to be open.
Bring your worry, grief, and pain. Every cause you have for shame, lay it all down. Lay it all down. When your cares have buried you, and there's nothing left to do. Just want to sit at your feet, oh God. Just want to lay back against you, Jesus. Breathe.
We're building a life on a firm foundation. Don't sit down. Don't sit down. This is a part of the worship that we're going to continue to do. Right? This is a celebration. It's a continue of worship. We're about to go into our offering. I want to give you some time to prepare. But focus on those words. We're building a life. And it's a firm foundation. I know the servers are coming. I want you to come and stand next to me. We're going to pray over the offering as the people prepare. Come stand next to me. And think about the life that you're trying to build right now. That the foundational bricks are being set right now. And they're going to carry you through. So I'm going to ask Tony to pray over the offering as we're about to enter in.
Lord, we thank you for those who are about to give. Lord, we thank you for your presence here among us. We thank you for your provision in every way. This is just a part of that, Lord. We give you thanks. We ask your blessings upon it so we continue your work. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, sir.
We set in our hearts that we will not be shaken. We set in our hearts, Lord, that in no realm in our life will we be shaken. Not because of anything that we do or anything that we are, but because of you. Yes. Lord, we thank you that you are relentless in pursuing us for life. For wholeness, for freedom. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your relentless, relentless love. Just continue to breathe you in, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. I want to pray over the children as they go. Lord, thank you for these little ones. Thank you, Lord.